IT Idiots would like to thank UK2.net for sponsoring the show, the UK's largest provider of web hosting, providing the content and bandwidth distribution for this show.
Okay, welcome to IT Idiots episode 25. My name's Nicholas Hill and I'm joined once again by...
Nikki Curtis, hi.
And so, hello Nikki, we haven't seen you for a couple of weeks, been away. And,
yeah, you've been on holiday, haven't you?
I haven't been on holiday, I've been away on a business trip.
Business trip, what work do you do?
Well, I went to an exhibition and had 5 days holiday.
How long was your exhibition?
A day.
And was it good? Did you sell? What did you actually do?
No, I just went to visit.
Okay.
I was a tourist.
Right.
So, yeah.
And you didn't take your crap little car, did you?
I didn't, no. Oh, I flew and then I hired a nice powerful car.
What, a TT?
No. An Audi RS4.
Okay.
So, it's quite powerful. Big V8 engine.
Better than mine?
Sorry?
Better than mine?
Well, it's 400 brake horsepower.
Yeah, but what about
with
on
a
track?
With a V8 engine, I think it'd absolutely annihilate your car.
What about not 60? What's that?
4 seconds.
Yeah, it's bollocks.
4.2 bollocks. Or something. It is. It's something
okay. Anyway.
Let's not get all geeky. So, what else? Right, can I just have my 30 seconds of rant?
Yeah.
Really disappointed with Samsung.
Camera.
Yeah, the camcorder. We bought a £120 camcorder. And apparently, to expect it to last a year is just unreasonable.
It was.
2 weeks later, and they've only just collected it. So I contacted them and asked them why it took 2 weeks to collect when it was meant to be collected within sort of 48 hours. And they said, well, we're extremely busy. Can I get somebody to call you back 3 times?
That's a bloody nightmare. Because it's not worth anything, really. You might as well just chuck it away, but it's really...
It's the principle, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
So I phoned them up again. Anyway, finally got collected. They quoted 5 days to get fixed. I thought that's quite reasonable. I phoned the company that are fixing it.
Uh-huh.
They're quoting 4 to 5 weeks.
Joy.
To actually fix it and send it back. So I got in touch with Samsung's PR people. So I thought, well, I'll give them an opportunity to quote on it for the podcast. And I had an email saying, we're away until the 16th of October.
So don't buy Samsung.
So at the moment, my feeling here is don't buy Samsung. You know, if we can swing it in any way that Samsung decide they want to do something because of the podcast and the many hundreds of thousands of viewers that we have, then we'll let you know.
So but, what have we got now then? What's that?
So I bought a Panasonic 3CCD camcorder.
Oh, yeah. So much better.
Supposedly, I mean, obviously, by the time I've compressed this down to
cost?
Fuck.
How much does that cost?
It costs £350.
£350, so still cheap, really.
Still pretty good.
And of course, with the donations, we must be able to pay for the lens cap.
I was going to say, we're at least up to the lens cap.
Cheers, guys.
Yeah, so I'll be knocking you up for a bit of cash when you come back off your holiday.
Yeah, which I'm going to America, actually, to see all the fans.
Yep.
Yeah, a wonderful place called Boulder.
You're going to Colorado? No,
Boulder's in Denver.
Denver's in Colorado.
It shows us how much we know.
You're going to somewhere in America, aren't you?
Yeah, somewhere in America. It's quite a small place, just like England is.
Okay.
You know, if you've got any relatives over here, we probably know them.
Certainly met the Queen.
Exactly.
So apologies for the fact that we have to film ahead a little bit sometimes to sort of cater for work and travel and things. So you'll have to just bear with us. So what else? I appreciate that you might not want to donate to us and the podcast, but my poor cat, he had a bit of an accident.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So,
you haven't really quite got enough money to sort it out, and, you know, it's either that or we put it down.
Yeah, really. So...
We can't even afford a vet to put it down, so we have to get a hammer or something, I guess.
Have to do it ourselves. Yeah. I'm going to put a picture up of Barney the cat. And I'm hoping that might spur people on to actually maybe make a donation.
Mm.
Because quite honestly, if your cat gets injured and you haven't got insurance, excuse me.
Luckily, my cats are all right, aren't they?
Yeah, your cats.
I could threaten to injure them without donations. Anna! perhaps not.
Just in case somebody phones the RSPCA. You've already been there once.
Yeah, someone actually thrown the RSPCA on me.
I've got to
explain this because I'm not into this sort of beating up cats.
You're very kind to your cat.
You know, but they got in a fight, and I think one of the neighbours saw, because, you know, in London, you don't talk to your neighbours. That's just totally out of question. People upstairs, they moved in about 4 weeks ago. No, probably about 2 months ago. And I haven't even said hi yet.
They said hello to me.
Did they?
Must be something about you.
I think
they're
avoiding me, yeah.
So you don't injure cats. You're not abusive towards your pets.
No.
Just a complete misunderstanding. No. And so... Yeah. On that high note, let's move on to technology.
So you're going to do some work this week, Nick, aren't you?
I'm going to do a podcast. I know many of you out there have been dying for me to do another presentation. A bit nervous about it now. I notice you've got a nice new fit covering on your MacBook.
Well, you know the problems I have with the MacBook. I think
fingerprints.
What they've done is they seem to replace the shell, because the shell's definitely different. You don't get any fingerprints on it. And it definitely feels a bit rougher as well, so it's not fingerprinting as much as it did before.
And those big gouge marks of the 666 that you put in the cover seem to have disappeared. So, this week we're going to... Well, back to me, so obviously it's going to be, from a technical point of view, a little bit less...
Substandard.
Yeah, I was going to say, a little bit less on the technical side.
Unlike my Vista episode.
Yeah, people liked the Joomla episode, so following on my limited knowledge. No, people were saying, you know, Joomla's great, but what can I do if I want to just sort of have a very light website, somewhere where I can essentially just do a blog? I mean, blog seems to be all the rage. 17.8 million of them in China, apparently.
Clogging up the tube.
Apparently so. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at a product called WordPress and look at getting that installed and how to go about doing a very, very simple video blog and posting that up onto your website. So WordPress, let's switch to it. Let's put ourselves up into the corner. We're obviously nice and widescreen, and this is all...
You're mucking around the format again, aren't you?
I'm playing.
You're always chopping and changing.
You know me. I'm into a bit of tinkering. So WordPress, you've probably all heard about it, or people talking about it.
I haven't.
I don't
really deal with free stuff.
You don't keep up with it.
Not
really keep
stuff,
up.
No.
So essentially what it is a very, very lightweight content management system. But rather than having to really get into depth about knowing about your... a little bit with Joomla, you have to put a bit of time and effort into it. WordPress is, as I say, a much lighter version, much simpler to learn, much simpler to install, and we're just going to go about setting this up. We were looking at doing it under Ubuntu, but we thought we'll look at Ubuntu later on.
We don't really know too much about that in the Avron. We ended up with a podcast like the Vista one again.
We will. So essentially what we're going to do is we're going to, over the next few weeks, intersperse looking at a few essentially open source products and how they might be of use to people.
Cool.
So let's start with WordPress. So the website is wordpress.org. I've actually already downloaded it. I've downloaded basically the install.
So you did some planning.
Yeah, the install files. So I've got a few files to install here.
So it's a web server.
It is. Essentially, it's a web server. So
was it? So does it integrate with IIS or it's
no? It's going to require PHP, Apache. Again, your standard sort of open source, free to use web servers. So what we're actually going to do is we're going to very, very quickly install all of that under a Windows platform.
Gotcha.
Now, obviously, if you wanted to use WordPress, you're going to want to host it for the world to be able to see. So what you'd probably actually do is you'd probably buy a hosting package, and one of those hosting packages will specialize in WordPress, and you can actually probably have a WordPress pre-installed for you,
Okay. Or
at the click of a button install it. But obviously, we need to emulate this to learn how to use it under
a
Windows environment. So we're going to go back and reinstall one of our favorite products, Vertigo. So
was that the installer type thing?
Yeah. So
I did listen to you.
Yeah. So we installed this. So I won't spend too much time going through this. We installed this when we did Joomla to give us that what they call WAMP.
What's that?
Windows, Apache, MySQL, PHP.
So you're a bit of a WAMPer.
Something like that. Mm. So it's not LAMP, is it? Because that'd be Linux.
Yeah, I must find out about LAMP, actually.
We did have a... Who was that guy? He had a great name.
That was James, wasn't it?
Strusselberger something or other. IT.
Are you going off track? Is this okay?
Yeah, because he actually asked... He actually had a post. It's relevant. Apart from
that. And you've been exchanging private emails with Des, haven't you? Is it Des?
Yeah, it might have been. Don't embarrass him. He, you know... He's a good guy.
I know. I feel a bit threatened after what you told me.
Oh, Big Lee.
Apparently he knows his stuff. Oh, we got a new post.
Well, No, that was... His episode suggestions. Yeah, you actually bothered to reply. There you go, Lamp.
I do reply, I'm just busy.
Lamp, see? Yeah. By Jason Segmiller. That's how I'm going to pronounce it. Do you want to pronounce it differently?
Segmiller.
Okay, fair enough. One of the two is probably going to be fairly close. He apologises for the fact that he called us Australian, but loves our accent.
Yeah, I saw that, and I was kind of a bit busy at work, quickly scanning through it, and I thought there was a point to it, but I didn't have time to understand the email. It's
outrageous assuming we're Australian. And we don't have accents, we're English.
The rest of the world have accents.
Yeah, yeah.
We're English.
English, English. So the rest of the world has an accent, we don't. So there we go.
An accent, I sort of see it as more of a speech impediment.
Okay. That's fair enough. So Jason was interested in LAMP, but it'll have to be WAMP for the time being. But he did bring up quite an interesting topic, which you're going to look at covering. And if you want to tell the boys and girls.
What, LAMP?
No, I'm doing WAMP, which is a version of LAMP. He was interested in Exchange 2007.
It's mentioning Beatery stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I can't remember, can I?
So do you want to tell the boys and girls what we might be looking at over coming weeks?
Yeah, I had a bit of an idea. I know we're chopping and changing all the time, but we thought we'd start looking at some of the new technologies from Microsoft.
Yeah, I think that sounds reasonable.
So Exchange 2007 and SMS4 or whatever it's called now, System Center, blah. As I call it. So yeah, it'd be good, and it'd be easy for me to do, and not easy for me to do, but it'd be helpful for me.
It'd be useful for your job.
Exactly.
And it would probably piss a few people off at work, the fact that you've already got in there, done a podcast.
I've done it, I'm internationally famous.
Been there, done it, mate,
yeah.
So do you notice last month, I know going off track here a little bit, 10,000 downloads.
I know, it's getting pretty scary, really.
It is.
It's getting a little scary.
10,000 downloads. I was well chuffed with that. So anyway, I've installed it, and I'm just going to, as part of the post process, says, do you want to actually run it? So I'm going to say yes, and it's as simple as that. This is now running PHP.
You can hear it over there.
There we go. And I'm going to... No, I don't want to keep blocking. I'm going to unblock it.
I think I have a problem if you...
Unblock it. So that is now running Apache, MySQL, PHP, up and down.
Is that all installed and everything?
Yeah.
And it's all actually running?
Yeah. That's how lightweight it is.
Nah.
It does make Microsoft products seem a bit wanky, doesn't it? Can I say wanky?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
Because I don't think it's in the dictionary.
Okay, that's great. So...
the English dictionary.
We've got that up and running. What I'm now going to do is I'm going to take the WordPress files that I've downloaded and extracted.
Uh-huh.
So that will just involve people doing a WinZip. I think gotcha. they can probably manage that.
If not, you shouldn't own a computer, really.
Probably not. So I'm going to literally take that WordPress file, that WordPress folder, and I'm going to go up to where it's installed it. Now, the default, I don't quite like this, but I couldn't be asked to change the settings.
And this is how you normally have your Explorer set up, isn't it, with things hidden?
No, it's not. It's just that he refused to let me put this on one of our XP machines.
He was going to actually put it on... I'm running Bootcamp on this, and XP's running at the moment, but he was actually wanted to use that. But instead, I've given him a VMware XP machine running over there, and I'm making him RDP to it.
He didn't trust me with the stuff
I don't want this free install. Stuff, I don't trust it.
It's charming, isn't it? So I'm going to put the WordPress folder into the www folder. So that's essentially your IIS root.
Gotcha, WIIS root. So, I understand that.
And what we're now going to do is...
Did they copy Microsoft then?
No, they were here before Microsoft, I'm joking. Mate. Before, I tell you.
I know.
So
I've got a lot of respect for open source stuff, really.
Next thing to do for WordPress is, what we're going to do is we're going to go up here, edit. How do I rename?
File rename. Yeah, we're running it on the Mac and it's having a bit of a problem with the right click.
Oh, like you don't. Right, so we're going to just remove the sample bit. We're going to go into here and we're going to file.
It's quite very impressive.
Just got to edit this. So I'm going to choose WordPad. So what we're going to do is we're just going to edit the config file for...
See, I would use Notepad, personally.
No, but WordPad wraps it.
It does with Notepad if you go for file WordWrap. Or...
Right, okay.
Did you want to make use of the fonts available in WordPad?
I'll kill you in a minute.
Okay.
Right, so username is going to be root. The password, obviously, when you're setting this up in a proper environment, you might want to change a few things. But Vertigo is the password, localhost, database is going to be WordPress. So all I've done is just changed a couple of the definitions in this file. So I'm going to save that and close it. Next thing to do is to fire up Explorer. Now, obviously, I did ask you to put Firefox on, which you promised you were going to do.
I didn't actually promise.
You did?
No, I didn't.
Right. Local host. I'm going to F11 that, if that's okay. Just take it full screen.
I'm surprised you knew that, isn't it?
Thanks, mate.
That's right.
So I'm going to go to PH. Right, so go to localhost, and what this has done is, for Vertigo, it's installed a sort of a control panel from the front end. I can see what packages are installed: Apache, PHP, MySQL, SQLite, PHP MyAdmin. And what I'm going to do is, I'm actually going to go to PHP MyAdmin.
Were all of those installed whilst we were filming?
Yeah.
You didn't do any preparation on that?
No, none whatsoever.
That was pretty.
It's quite impressive, isn't it? It's so light. Trigo. Okay. So what this has done is it's brought us into here. Databases. What I'm actually going to do is I'm just going to create a new database, and I'm going to call this WordPress. So what this is just an HTML front end onto MySQL. So this allows you to manage your databases, create users, edit tables, anything that you would normally do.
Gotcha, yeah.
And you can do it through a PHP, PHP HTML front end. So I'm going to create just a standard database. It's created it. And what I'm now literally going to do is F11 again, so I can get this back. Database has been created. And what I'm now going to do is I'm going to install WordPress. wp/admin/install. Oh, I'm sorry. PHP. So let's just F11 that again. So this is literally just going to take us through the couple of steps that's involved in installing WordPress. So what should we call it? We'll call it...
I find this really weird, you know, installing stuff through a website, you know.
Nikki's first blog.
Mine.
Nikki, well, I've already had a blog.
Okay.
It would be a lie to say that this was my first blog. At IT. Crack, I didn't want to give away your Gmail account.
No, the thing is, when people. I often respond from the Gmail, and people catch me on chat sometimes.
But that's because you've chosen to reply from your Gmail account.
Yeah, well, I don't mind.
At least this way, nikki.curtis@itidiots.com covers up the fact that it's at gmail.com.
Yeah, it's true.
Well, it did, obviously, until I just mentioned that. Yeah. So there we go, just configuring this up. Now we're going to create the database tables and fill them. Done. So what we need to do is we just need to make a note of the admin password that it's just created for us, because I won't remember that because I'm a bit stupid.
Limited.
Right, so let's go to the... let's log in. So the first time you go in, it's firing up a few services, so it can take a few seconds, but there we go, we're in pretty quickly. Now what we're in here is we're in the back-end admin side of things. A much, much lighter version from those of you who actually watched the Joomla one. What we've got here is we've got a few straightforward options, which we're going to go through in a moment. But it's a much lighter version, so much, much easier to be able to get up and running. First thing I'm going to do is just go into here and actually just come down here and change that... password, because I won't remember it otherwise.
Excuse me.
So just update my profile. Done. So I'll tell you what we're going to do. Oh, I was going to control tab, but I can't do that, can I? Because you didn't put Firefox on there for me. So let's go back to this window, and what we're going to do is we're just going to go to localhost/WordPress. Nikki's first blog. It's fairly bland, fairly basic, not really much going on. But we can see this is...
It sort of mimics my life quite accurately.
Yeah, I mean, it's put in a Hello World article in there. And so we've got a fairly basic website here that's not really doing very much. So what we're going to do is we're going to go in and make a couple of changes to this. Let's just show people how easy it is to actually do something. So what we'll do is we'll keep this window up as the front end, this window as the back end.
Should have Firefox, really.
Sorry?
Should have Firefox, really.
It would have been nice, yeah. Wouldn't it? I think so. I think it would have just finished. It would have just been.
It would have been.
So, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to come back to the WordPress site, which obviously if I'd been tabs, you know.
Yeah.
But anyway, there we go.
It's lack of pressure. preparation, really, wasn't it?
By you.
By, it's your episode.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to WordPress here, and if we go to the Extend tab on their website, we can actually see that there are a couple of interesting things. The first one is a community theme viewer. And from here, what we can do is we can actually look at themes that people have designed and created for the websites. So what we can do is, for example, we can have a look at this one. And if we like the look of this one, we can download this and we can make our website look like it. Now, I liked this one, Traffic Lights, because it's Kingston, which is just
Kingston,
down the road.
Okay.
Kingston, London, by this guy here.
Whereabouts is that? Do you know?
Well, we'll come to that in a minute. We'll come to that in a minute. So I've already downloaded this, but I just thought I'd show you through their website. You can actually go to their theme viewer, and there are literally hundreds and hundreds of themes. Aquafluid. I don't know what that is, but it just...
Any adult themes?
I don't know.
Oh, I would just assume you'd know about those, that's all.
Charmed. Right, so here we go. We've got our WordPress...
They're not often charming.
We've got our WordPress folder. Sorry to muck you around. Just going to go back into and open up the podcast. I've actually already pre-downloaded this one, Traffic Lights. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to Control C on that, copy that folder, go back to WordPress, go back to WP Content, Themes. And all I'm going to do is Control V and paste that folder into there. Now, when I come back to the admin side of things, when I go to, excuse me, it's just gives a bit more presentation.
Real estate.
So we can see our current theme here.
Uh-huh.
But what it's actually done, it's been really, really... Why you...
It's been really, really clever, but you haven't.
Something along those, I know exactly what it is.
There's a broken theme there. Did you see that? It said broken theme, traffic lights.
Did it say
that?
Yeah,
yeah. There you go.
Style sheet's missing. That's really strange. Let's just have a quick look in there. Ah, that's right.
Ah, okay. Folder.
Flid.
Yeah.
Well, not in a sort of...
Have you got something against flids?
No. Well, I don't even know what one is.
No, not I.
Edit. Cut. Where's delete? There we go. No. Themes. How do I get rid of that on a Mac?
Just file delete. There you go.
File delete, yes. Right, that should have... Shh. Bloody Mac, sorry. Right, so let's just paste that into there.
Obviously just like that?
Just like that. So let's go back to here and F5 on this page. And
oh,
what we'll see...
it's not broken anymore.
There we go. So this is our current theme. And let's choose traffic light. So our current theme is now Traffic Light by Ronan Menton from Kingston. So let's now switch back to this, and let's F5 on this. Look.
Okay, what? Is it flooded?
Sorry?
It looks like Kingston's flooded. Oh no, it's car headlights.
It's like a car headlights. Nikki's first blog is the layout style of this. I mean, I don't think it's necessarily particularly great, but I liked it because it was Kingston. Do you know where that is?
Is that up by Nando's?
I don't know, it looks run down and destitute.
Wagamama's.
Looks run down and destitute, so it does look
like... Ashford.
May well be, but what we can see here is that it's changed slightly the style and layout. Theme designed by Malone Car Hire. This is advertising. Right, anyway, so what I've done is I've applied a theme to this very, very quickly and easily. Now,
can this coexist with Joomla? I'm just trying to think, can we integrate this on our site?
You wouldn't integrate this. What we probably should have done if we were sensible was actually probably do our site.
This.
Yeah, use this, a much lighter sort of product.
Yeah.
But obviously, we didn't. So I can't be asked to recreate IT Dits, can you? Just yet.
Well, there's not that much content on it, really, is there? To be honest.
You did promise to write some.
I did, and then I realised it's going to take longer than I initially thought. And we had enthusiasm in the start, didn't we?
In the early days, enthusiasm.
And now it's just a barrier, really, isn't it, to life?
To life. Right, okay, so based on that, well, I'm just going to close this down, but before I do, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back and just show you something else that's worth... Something over here on the left-hand side is called plugins of the WordPress website. I'm going to go to the codecs list, of plugin list, and what we're going to do is we're going to take a quick look at got a whole list of sort of categories for plugins. You can get a shop for this, all
a shop
sorts.
for my blog.
Yeah. So you can sell something. People normally sell a t-shirt or a mug off of their blog site.
Okay.
Do you reckon anyone ever buys them? There'd be a lot of mugs to buy if you visited a lot of blogs. Anyway, so I'm going to go to graphics, video and sound, because I promised that what we would do was put
on... Oh, a video blog.
Yeah. So I'm going to go to video.
Was it a vlog?
I think it's vlogging.
A vlog.
And the one I've been interested in is WP, I guess that's WordPress, FLV player. So that will play Flash video. So this is what we're going to look at installing. So you can download this from their website. I'm not going to spend too long going through their actual website. But what I am just going to do, because it makes...
You're just going to rape them of resources and not give them any credit.
No. They get the credit when you actually go and download
okay,
it.
Okay.
So I'm just going to minimise that. Now, I've obviously pre-downloaded this to keep the podcast snappy. And I'm going to take the Flash video player. Now, I'm not going to fall for that again. And I'm going to drag that and drop it into... will that take me up a directory? It won't, will it?
It does on a Mac.
It does on a Mac. Right, so I'm going to have to git. Cut that. Go up here. Up one more. I'm going to paste that into the root. And now what I'm going to do is just going to rename that folder. All will become apparent in a moment. Rename. And I'm going to call that... movies. No, sorry. I'm not. I'm going to change that. I'm going to take my time. Edit. No. File. Rename. Video. Sorry, that's much more relevant. What we're now going to do... I'll explain what we're doing here in just a second. I mean, I appreciate you. A man of your calibre, a teacher of your calibre, you explain it as you go.
I've got no idea where you got that from, and I don't like being referred to as that.
Okay. What's that? A man?
No, I think people... It turns out that sometimes I watch the episode, it looks like I'm a bit arrogant. I'm just not. I'm quite surprised that I can get away with it.
That you can be that arrogant. Okay, so essentially... No, I think I've been a bit poor here, because what I've downloaded from this site are two files. I've downloaded a Flash player, mm-hmm. and I've downloaded a script that allows you to activate that Flash player from within WordPress. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the content, and I'm going to go into plugins... And I'm going to literally just paste that script. Notice, done it again. View. See whether the audience are out there know what we're talking about.
Tools folder options.
View.
That's a bastard. That is. It always gets me.
Apply. Essentially, what I did was I downloaded a PHP script, and it decided that obviously means it's a text file. So it calls it PHP. It just gets me so many times, that does. Rename. It's PHP. Yeah. So now what we're going to do is going to come back to our back end.
It looks pretty nice, doesn't it? I like the website.
Yeah, go to plugins. And what we can see here is, see how it's noticed?
Yeah.
All it's done is it's just read that directory. And what we're going to do is we're going to activate that. So we click on activate. Plugins activated. What's quite nice is that now, if I was to just kill off this page here, I've installed it and I'm thinking, where did I get that from? It always has a link to the website that provides it and manages that plugin, which is quite useful. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to options. And now under options here, what I've got is the ability to manage those plugins, the configuration uh-huh. for a plugin. So what it needs to do is it needs to know where it can find the server-side Flash video
gotcha.
Player, which is what I downloaded and installed earlier on into video.
So we could
point
to our videos.itedits.com.
We could, in theory, for the player.
Because we get free streaming from there, don't we?
We do. /WordPress/video... Did I call it video or videos?
No, it's video.
It was video.
Yeah.
Lovely. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create another folder here. So I'm going to go file, new folder, and I'm going to call it blogs. And into that blogs, I'm actually going to copy a little blog I created earlier on. And I'm going to put that into the blogs folder.
Was that the video blog?
It's just a little video blog I recorded earlier on for the purposes of this. So let's go back to here. So we now know we now know where it can find its Flash video player.
Mm-hmm.
These are sort of a few default settings, which again people will be able to play around with and adjust according to how they want to do it. And that's pretty much the settings now for that. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go into the dashboard. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go to this Hello World post, and I'm actually going to just change the date it was created. I'll explain. This will be of relevance later on, so you'll just have to hang on a few minutes to find out why that is. Okay, so let's go to right under here, and again, this is all the back end this is all back end server side. So I'm going to put in here, Nikki's first video blog. Didn't want to do that. Now then, just going to. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just literally going to put in here the video post entry. So I'm going to put in Flav, which is the, again, this you can get all of this off of his website, the configuration for how to use the Flash video player within your blog. href equals.
Do you have to put in HTML?
No. HTTP colon double forward slash.
Local. You know your HTML, don't you?
Localhost. /WordPress/blog. Was it blog or blogs? It was blogs, wasn't it?
I think it's blogs, yeah.
blogs/blog.flav. width equals 400. Height equals 225, and then I think it's that. I think it is. So literally, all I've done is I've just put in a bit of HTML here. I believe there is a way of being able to do this, but I
that's just looking for that.
So I'm just going to publish that. Now then, with a little bit of luck, what we can do is we can come back to the front page. Nikki's first video blog. No, I got it wrong. I'm just going to edit that. And let's just make sure we got this right. Oh, we didn't update that, did we?
Oh, God.
Localhost, video, yeah, that's, no. Apologies about this. Didn't actually click the update option, which would be useful,
yeah.
One would have thought, anyway. There we go.
Wow.
Look at that. So, Nikki's first video blog. So, should we click it and see what it does? Right, okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're back. We found the problem. Because Nikki didn't put Firefox on, which automatically puts Flash Player on there for you.
Yeah, it's my fault.
We didn't have the Flash Player, because again, he wouldn't trust me with his machine. We had to have a fresh out-the-box Virgin machine. So what we've done is we're just going to quickly install Flash. I mean, I assume this has got an internet connection.
Well, what are you looking at now?
Thrash away the hard drive.
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Hey, there we go.
I can't wait to see my vlog.
You can't wait to see what? Your vlog. localhost /WordPress. You mean this one?
I can't wait.
The fact that we created Nikki's second video blog during the cut, just in case that was something to do with it. Maybe it needs a control F5. You motherfucker.
Close down IE and come back in again.
Yeah, that could be something to do with it. I thought, what a nice, simple, easy podcast to do.
I might rethink what to do next. Oh,
there we go. My very first video blog Hang on, what did I just do? I'm just ruining it for the ladies and gentlemen. I just want to get a bit of volume because we're not capturing sound. There we go, look.
Do you mind? I'm trying to record. It's approved. Okay, well, thank you very much.
There we go.
So, there we go. We've posted a video blog, eventually. Apologies about that.
How do you record the video blog thing?
Using a camera.
Oh, okay. No, I just wonder what the software required to record Flash.
Well, in fairness, I used a utility that converted... a WMV output file. I edited it.
But that could be any video format.
Get to any video format and it'll play it. Yeah,
high definition, couldn't it?
could be in theory. Mm. So yeah, one last thing just to mention. Essentially, what we've done is here we've created Nikki's first video blog and Nikki's second video blog because we thought there might have been a problem with the first. And here's the original article. Now remember, I changed the date on that, October 12th. Something neat that you kind of get with this is that you can come in here and on the opening page go, oh yeah, look, he did an entry on this.
Okay, that's pretty
day.
Good.
So I can go see the entries for the 12th, come in here and see what you wrote on the 12th, I can see what you did on the 14th. So for example, come down here and comments. Are there any comments? So I can leave a comment.
Okay. I can't wait for this. That's not. My hand's in it.
So there we go. And what I can do is I can now submit that.
It's good I always snapshotted this VMware machine before, isn't it? I can just undo this podcast and.
You can make it so that it never existed.
Yeah. You know you're Nicholas at itidiots.com and I'm Nicky, you're not Nicholas.hill.
Yeah, you created me a Nicholas.hill as well. There we go. And what we can see is somebody's now come along to the website and they've left a comment.
That's not even... Wow.
So, and people can take RSS feeds off of the comment. So it's a pretty neat...
Any comments from women yet?
No, because it's just on your local machine.
Oh, okay.
So... there we go. I mean, I just thought it'd be quite a neat little tool.
No, it's pretty nice, isn't it?
That anybody can really just create their own blog, I guess, on the internet, write articles. You can get loads of plugins for it and you can really tailor the way it looks and the stuff it does.
So you know the free websites you get with your ISP?
Yeah.
Could that support this kind of stuff?
Quite possibly. I mean, I guess as long as it didn't have commercial use and they did actually offer you the ability for MySQL... You know, for a back-end MySQL database. Just about every hosting package for a couple of dollars a month now will give you this kind of setup. In fact, whilst I was looking around, when I typed in WordPress, I saw an advert, your own WordPress website for $2 a month.
That's pretty
good. So, you can, everybody should be able, there should be no excuse why people don't have their own blog and their own web page now.
Apart from mine, which I've got nothing to put in it, really.
Well, I don't know, you put a picture of me. So yeah, you can manage the links, you can create links in here. I mean, I was going to extend it on, but obviously all the mistakes I've made now,
yeah, just drag, you just use up all the time and I just can't do anymore. Now what other stuff can it do? You're saying shopping carts and stuff it can do?
Oh yeah, you can get all sorts of crazy stuff for it. Let's just go back to their website because it looks better than ours. WordPress, let's just F11 this for the boys and girls. Extend. So let's go to some of the plugins. So obviously we looked at themes, but let's take a look at a couple of the plugins. I mean, there are a few sites that offer plugins, but according to this, administration, monetize, I would imagine it's under monetize.
So I don't really understand what this product really is. Light. So you could actually set up a web shop on it.
Yeah, you can set up you can install an e-commerce site into it. Essentially, if you think of it as
so, it's not really a blogging tool.
Well, it is. It's a content management, but designed for blogging. You know, and very lightweight website. So let's think about what people want to do. In the olden days, people used to sit there and write HTML pages, didn't they? And post those up, and they were static. If you wanted to change something, you edited it and re-uploaded it.
Yeah.
Whereas now what you can do is you can go to your website, you can log into your website, and you can just edit it in the back end. You know, like when you actually bother to make a couple of changes.
Yeah. I can see Joomla, what Joomla does.
Yeah, and this is, so this is just a very lightweight version of Joomla for somebody who's got their own personal website. And to be honest with you, loads of the blogs that you see on the internet now are done using WordPress. They get tens of thousands of downloads a month of this. So there you go. We all want you to now create your own blogs, video if possible. And I'll tell you what, anyone who does, we'll give it a shout. How's that?
Yeah, and we'll link to it.
And we'll link to it.
Members' blogs.
And if you could link to us, you might.
We just need people to watch.
Yeah.
So, we're fed up of making these forum posts all the time, aren't they?
It's a nightmare. What was your name again? Mr. Googleberger or something?
I don't know. I've got millions of names on there. I've registered so many times.
Anyway, so that's another episode. Yep. So I think until next week, we shall say adios.
Bye.
You shitbag, man.
Mic's not working today. I couldn't get that.
I just spat into my eyesight.
IT Idiots is sponsored by UK2.net, the UK's largest web hosting provider. With domains from just $1.99 and web hosting from just 40p a day, visit itidiots.uk2.net for weekly offers. Get your piece of the internet at uk2.net.
Eat! Paper! No! Move that melon of yours and get the paper if you can! Holland that gun, gank you and cranium about!
Get that boy's head like Sputnik!
Miracle, but quick, pointy in the mouth!
Well, that was also, wasn't it? He'll be crying himself to sleep tonight on his huge pillow.